Hey there, hobby homesteaders. Welcome back to Peak's Peak. Today, we're going to quickly go through the steps of removing your backhoe and putting it back on again. I've got a 2019 Kubota BX23S, and different models may have a few different procedures, but the main premise will be the same in removal and installation of the backhoe. So we're going to go through that process today, step by step, and show you how to quickly and easily remove the backhoe and put it back on again, and some things to watch out for, that way you don't get yourself in a bind. This is a very simple process, something anybody can do. So if you own one of these tractors, you need to be able to take it off and put it back on again. So we're gonna take care of that today. Now, as we get started, I'll tell you, I store my backhoe under a lean-to equipment shed, and I've got pallets that I lower it down onto. There are also some great racks and dollies that you can purchase to set your backhoe down on. That way, if you have a concrete building that you store your backhoe attachment in, you can put it on that attachment. It has wheels on it. You can roll it around the shop, and that would be great if that's your setup. But for me, I'm basically just parking mine under a shed. So rather than get under the shed where the lighting is not great and I have all kinds of other equipment in the way, I decided to just get out here in the yard and show you the process and kind of give you an idea of what you need to be doing. So to begin with, we're gonna fire up the tractor and we're going to run the RPMs up enough to work the hydraulics, and we'll lower down the outriggers and we will extend the boom out and flatten the bucket. After you have extended your boom and set your bucket down flat and you've lowered your outriggers, not touching the ground, just within a few inches of the ground, spread out, you're going to take your boom and press down with the arm to raise those back tires up off of the ground. And that will take the pressure off of the jaws on your locks. So you'll pull out on that lever, twist it, and push it back into the slot. And that locks it in the open position. So you'll undo that lock on both sides of the backhoe. Then you're going to set the back of the tractor down slowly. And as you do that, the backhoe will tilt itself away from the tractor. And you'll see it pivot in the little hooks that it's sitting in. And you'll pivot it down. Once you've got it pivoted all the way down, then you use your outriggers to pick it up out of that little cradle. And it's away from the tractor. Then you can slowly pull away just far enough to disconnect your hydraulic cables. Then you'll go ahead and shut off the machine and unhook those hydraulic connections. One quick note, before you disconnect your backhoe connections, you want to lower your bucket all the way to the ground, put it in float mode, and then shut the tractor off. And then I pull the lever back and I move it in all directions to kill all of the hydraulic pressure. That way when you disconnect, there's no pressure left on that. Now, there are times when if you leave your backhoe sitting out for a while and it bleeds down, temperature changes come along, then your hydraulic pressures will be affected by that, and you may have difficulty reconnecting your hydraulic connections. Now, I have found that most of the time that can be corrected by moving the loader arm around and relieving the pressure on the tractor itself, and I can get the first one connected to the tractor and then go from there, and I'm able to get it connected. Some people have such a high pressure on their lines that the only way that they can get relief in their lines so they can get them connected is to loosen the flat face connectors on the hoses to allow some of the pressure to bleed off. If you do that, throw a rag over the top of it to keep it from spraying out in case there's a lot of pressure. Shouldn't be that much pressure, but you do that for safety and make sure it doesn't spray out. loosen those connections, let the pressure off, close it back up, and if there's any air gets in there, it'll bleed itself out in the system. So that's no concern. That's a worst case scenario. I've never had to do that on my machine, and I leave it stored for months at a time sometimes. And then there are other times when I'm taking it on and off, you know, every few days. So one time, the right angle flat face connector on the tractor, I used a rubber mallet and I kind of tapped on it and got it to pop in. And that's the most difficulty that I've had in connecting mine, but I've read that others have had some more issues come up. So if you encounter that, easiest way is to let that pressure off before you go connect it. Let's go back through the process and put this thing back on. So when you get ready to put your backhoe back on the machine, of course you back up to it. You're going to back up until the bars on the backhoe that fit down in the little cradle are right up against the machine, and then you will hop off. And you'll use your outriggers that raised it up out of that slot to lower it back down into the cradle that it sits in. Once it drops into its cradle where it goes, then you can use the backhoe arm to push down and raise the tractor back up off of the ground just a little bit to take the tension off. So you can close those jaw locks. You can put that bar back in between the jaws. And you do that by just the opposite of the way we locked them in place open. You pull out on it, let the tension off to where the bar goes back inside the jaws, and you're locked back in place. Once you've locked both sides in, then you can go ahead and lower the tractor back down on the ground slowly, raise your arm up, curl your bucket in to the home position, raise up your outriggers, and you're done. It's just that simple. There's nothing at all difficult about putting the backhoe on and taking it off. It really is a brilliant design that makes it very efficient. I've mentioned in other videos, one of the only pains that I have in dealing with the backhoe system is the three-point hitch setup has to come off first. And the three-point hitch setup honestly takes as long or longer to take off as it does to put the backhoe on. So, very simple process. I hope that you picked up a few tips that will help you out in taking your backhoe off and putting it back on. If you've got other suggestions or if I overlooked something, be sure and leave that in the comments. If it's a big enough suggestion, I'll pin it to the top, so make sure everybody sees it. We just want to make this easier for everybody. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I hope you found a few tips that'll help you out in using your Kubota BX23S. I appreciate y'all watching. You all have a good day.